Dear learners, welcome to the channel Learn Through Digital. In our channel, now I introduce a new playlist for the course Antennas and Microwave Engineering. It will be helpful for the learners to understand the concepts related to the antennas and microwave engineering. You can download the videos related to various types of antennas and the microwave components and the devices. Welcome to the course Antennas and Microwave Engineering. Here in this video, I will talk about Introduction to Antennas and Microwave Engineering. So in this video, I am going to talk what are the topics in the course and what are the major applications of antennas and microwaves in our day-to-day life. First, let us start with the course outline. The course outline, the first unit covers Introduction to Microwave Systems and Antennas. In this unit, we will discuss about the basics of antenna parameters and what are the microwave frequency bands. In the second unit, it deals with the radiation mechanism and the design aspects. Under this title, we will discuss about the radiation mechanism of various antennas, linear, wire and loop antennas, aperture antennas, reflector antennas, microstrip antenna, and frequency independent antennas. And also we will discuss about the design consideration of all antennas and also discuss about the applications of each and every antenna. In the third unit, we will talk about the antenna arrays and applications. Group of antenna elements are nothing but array. Then how we build the antenna arrays. There are different types of antenna arrays. It may be the uniformly spaced arrays and with the uniform and non-uniform excitation or amplitudes. And also we will discuss smart antennas. In the unit 4 and 5, we will discuss about the microwave components and the devices. In the unit 4, we shall discuss about the microwave devices for both the active and passive devices. And also in the unit 5, we'll discuss about the amplifiers, oscillators, mixers. These are the topics in under the course Antennas and Microwave Engineering. The first 3 unit covers the topics related to antennas. The remaining 2 unit covers the topics related to microwave engineering. I referred 2 textbooks, for one for antennas and another for microwave engineering. For antenna topics, I referred John D. Cross, The Antennas and Wave Propagation, 4th edition. And David Poza, title is Microwave Engineering. I referred this book for the microwave devices and components. And 2 more textbooks, I referred. One is Balanus, Antenna Theory, Analysis and Design for Antenna Topics. And Foundations for Microwave Engineering by Colin for Microwave Engineering Topics, and for 2 more textbooks. Let's start with the topic with the electromagnetic spectrum. We will discuss this electromagnetic spectrum in detail in another video. Just we look about this electromagnetic spectrum. It covers the entire range of frequencies of radiation. The radiation, there are 2 major categories, non-ionizing and ionizing radiation. So the electromagnetic spectrum starts from very low frequency to the gamma rays, and we will discuss about each and every frequency range and applications in another separate video. I have explained the electromagnetic spectrum in detail. And the microwave frequency range, we are going to focus on this microwave frequency bands. These bands are designated as L band, S band, C band, X band, Q band, K band, Qua band, P, W band, MM band. These are the various frequency range under microwave frequency bands. And here I have listed some frequency bands and applications of the frequency bands. Why I am listing here, these are mostly used in our day-to-day life. We are using mobile phone and Wi-Fi. That's why I listed particular applications here. For FM radio, the frequency range is 82 to 108 MHz. For CDMA, 824 to 890 MHz. For GSM 900, the frequency range 890 to 915 and 935 to 960 MHz. For the GPS, it is 1575 plus or minus 10 MHz. GSM is 1800. And for 3G, the frequency range is 1920 to 1980. And also it is 2110 to 2070 MHz. That is 2.12 to 2.17 GHz. For the 3G range, the frequency range is 2.3 to 2.4 GHz. Wi-Fi frequency range is 2.4 to 2.483 GHz and also 5.2 to 5.8 GHz band. For satellite and defense communications, we are using high frequency to the millimeter wave band frequencies. These are some frequency bands used for particular applications, FM radio, GSM, Wi-Fi and 3G and 4G. And here I have listed some of the applications of microwave. Microwave application, it comprises of three major categories. One is civil application, military application and medical applications. Wireless communication, vehicle collision avoidance, remote sensing or comes under the civil applications. For the military applications, it is used for aircraft safety and navigation, radar, missile guidance and control. Under the medical applications, microwave radiations are used to detect cancer and tumor, and also it is used for therapeutic for the cancer diagnostics and therapy. We are using a microwave radiation. So it comprises of three major applications: civil, military and medical applications. Next we will discuss about the advantages of microwaves. First one is the larger bandwidth because we can send more information within that range compared to other frequency range. It provides a large bandwidth, better directivity and the size of the antenna getting reduced. So small size of antenna and low power consumption, effect of fading, these are all the advantages of microwaves. It has its own disadvantages. One is line of sight will be disrupted if any obstacles such as new buildings are in the way. First disadvantage. The second one is signal absorption by the atmosphere. Microwaves suffer from attenuation due to atmospheric condition. Depends upon the atmospheric condition and the attenuation of the signal disturb. And the third one is towers are expensive to build. And here I have listed a few examples for the microwave components. Generally, it can be categorized as passive microwave and active microwave components. Transmission lines, antenna, power divider, combiner, coupler, filter, attenuator or comes under passive microwave components. And active microwave components are amplifier, oscillator, mixer, RF switch, phase shifter. We'll discuss these components in detail in separate videos. One by one we will discuss about it. And this is the illustration for the transmission line and waveguides. And here I have illustrated antennas, examples for the antennas. We have seen these antennas. At our home, we are using this type of antenna, the reflector antenna. Generally, we called as dish antenna. In the earlier days, we are using Yagi-Uda antenna for television signal reception. And this is monopole antenna. And other types of antennas, horn antenna, helical antenna, microstrip patch antenna. Horn antenna, we are using this type of antenna in our laboratory. And this helical antenna is generally used in satellite communication, the radar communication. Microstrip antenna, it adopts a printed circuit technology. Most of the research is going on this microstrip patch antenna. We'll discuss in detail in separate videos. And another microwave passive components are microwave divider and combiner. The divider, it may be the 2-way, 3-way or 4-way divide. It divides the power and power is given to the particular microwave components. and coupler. There are various types of couplers, branch line directional coupler and coupled line directional couplers. And filters. Filters are a best example for the passive microwave component. There are various types, low pass, high pass, band pass and band reject filters. Here this photo, it illustrates a 7th order low pass filter. It also adopts the printed circuit technology. Passive microwave components, and one more example is attenuator. The attenuator, it may be the fixed attenuator or a variable attenuator. In the fixed attenuator, the attenuation range is 3 dB, 10 dB, 20, 30 dB ranges available. The power handling capacity of the fixed attenuator is 0.5, 5, 20, 100 watts. For the variable attenuator, it is available in the range of 3 to 30 dB. Power handling capacity is 0.5 watts. Okay, we may use a SMA and N-type connector for the attenuator. And another example is the amplifier. Amplifier, it is a low noise amplifier, medium power amplifier and high power amplifier. These are the various amplifiers. Amplifiers are the best example for the active microwave components because it's capable of generating a microwave power. And amplifier means it amplifies the given input signal. And the oscillator is one more example. And mixers. And RF switch and phase shifters. This figure, it illustrates RF switch and phase shifter. And here I mentioned a few examples for the microwave systems. Mobile phone is the best example for the microwave system. In our hand, we are always carrying a mobile phone. This is the best example. And the mobile phone jammer, generally we fix this mobile phone jammer in colleges or hospitals. And repeater signal enhancer, it enhances the signal. It is mostly used for the long distance communication. And RFID, RF transceivers, GPS, RF transceivers, GPS and GSM modules, radar, RF energy harvesting, microwave equipment like spectrum analyzer, vector network analyzer or some of the examples for the microwave equipment and the high power microwave systems. These are a few examples for the microwave systems. So we conclude this video with a few points. Nowadays our technology is rapidly growing. There is a lot of changes in the development of the antenna and the wireless communication systems. Therefore, it's very necessary in the development of 5G and IoT, Internet of Things. The basic requirement for innovating things to meet the demands and challenges. And the major key thing is design of antenna and microwave components. Thank you.